Hi, let's move to the future of communication and semiconductor devices, that is metamaterial. In this video, we'll be focusing mainly on its application as an antenna. Metamaterial. The word metamaterial comes from the Greek word meta, which means to go beyond, as they exhibit optical properties beyond anything that can be found in nature. These are nanocomposite structures made up of materials like metals or plastics. Metamaterials are artificial periodic structures of meta-atoms with lattice constants that are much smaller than the wavelength of the incident radiation, therefore providing negative refractive index characteristics to them.
Classification of electromagnetic material. Materials can be classified on the basis of electric permittivity epsilon and magnetic permeability mu in four quadrants as shown. In the first quadrant, where both epsilon and mu are positive, represents right-handed material. Electric vector E, magnetic vector H, and wave vector K forms the right-handed triplet as shown in the figure. The second quadrant, where epsilon is negative and mu is positive, describes electric plasmas, which support evanescent decaying waves. It is also called epsilon-negative materials. The fourth quadrant, where epsilon is positive and mu is negative, also supports evanescent decaying waves corresponding to mu-negative materials. The third quadrant, where both epsilon and mu are negative, represents metamaterials. These materials are also called left-handed materials or double negative materials. Due to negative mu and negative epsilon, the refractive index of this medium is also negative. Thus, these materials are also called negative index materials. Electric vector E, magnetic vector H, and wave vector K form the left-handed triplet as shown.
What is the effect of negative refractive index materials on Snell's law? When light comes in contact with a naturally occurring material such as glass or water, then it always bends at a positive angle as they have a positive refractive index. However, by using small amount of metals with a carefully designed structure, light would bend at a negative angle, showing that they have a negative refractive index. A metamaterial structural unit cell is a combination of SRR, split ring resonator, and wire structure. Metamaterials are usually implemented in a recurring structure of these unit cells. So, how is negative refractive index achieved? Let's first have a look at how is negative permittivity achieved. A three-dimensional array of intersecting thin wires could be used to create negative values of permittivity. The expression for relative permittivity is as shown. Here, omega p is the plasma frequency and omega is the frequency of the propagating EM wave. From this equation, the effective permittivity is negative when the frequency is below the plasma frequency. To achieve negative permeability, array of copper split ring resonators could be used. A split ring resonator is constructed by two concentric metallic rings, each having a gap, which are placed 180 degree apart. The gap between the rings acts as a capacitor, while the rings itself act as an inductor, resulting in an LC resonant circuit. So a combination of thin wires, which will give us negative permittivity, and SRR, which will give negative permeability, would together give us negative refractive index materials.
Using metamaterial as an antenna has the following advantages. It steps up the radiated power, it is small, it has increased directivity, it can enhance the gain, and it reduces the return loss of the patch antenna. These advantages will be further discussed in the next slide.
How does an antenna work? An antenna is an arrangement of one or more conductors, usually called elements. At transmitter, an alternating current is created in the elements which cause them to radiate electromagnetic field. In the reception, these fields are received and the reverse process occurs. Let's come to the basic working of a metamaterial antenna. Its working is similar to that of a normal antenna, it just exploits some of the properties of metamaterial to increase its efficiency, like small size. With small modification to the SRR structure, the size of the antenna could be reduced to 1/50th of the wavelength of the incident radiation.
Another advantage of using metamaterial antenna is its increased directivity and it enables long distance transmission. The radiating elements of such antennas are combined into large antenna arrays, as shown in the diagram. This provides the advantage of enabling long distance signal propagation. Mutual coupling occurs because individual antenna elements are closely spaced, which is necessary to generate highly directional beam. Metamaterial antennas step up the radiated power by impedance matching. The power radiated by electrically small antennas can be notably increased by surrounding an antenna with a shell of a double negative material. The double negative material shell matches the intrinsic reactance of this antenna system to free space, providing a natural matching circuit to the antenna. Thus, it creates maximally transmissive and minimally reflective electromagnetic materials using metamaterials. All these advantages of metamaterial antennas make their use more beneficial than regular antennas. The first cell phone to use a metamaterial antenna is LG Chocolate BL40. These metamaterial antennas also make better satellite antennas.
Thanks for watching. I hope you have understood the concept of metamaterial antenna.